Adobe Character Animator recently introduced body behavior in beta. It is tracking body nicely, but I found it's complicated to find a good position and arms keep bending and being distorted in strange ways. To keep the character look nice in a wide range of position and gestures, I propose to use a joint angles instead in order not to transform the mesh too much. We will be using custom development for Adobe Character Animator to make our controls happen, so if you want to replicate and follow along, you will need to review this video first and create the infrastructure to do all that. Today we will review an example of a right hand, how can we use it to control our character, and how can we flip the wrist automatically when we need to. We will also ensure that there is no weird distortions and our character is actually intact and useful in any position. The first thing to pay attention is the fact when I move my arm from inside to outside my body, my program can detect it. And the way this happens is you take the base of our wrist and we compare it with the shoulder line. And whenever we cross it, we know that our arm is inside now, and we trigger the behavior that changes the arc in our character. To grab the files, you'll need to follow to the GitHub repository and download the files that you can see on the screen right now. After you open HTML file, the body tracking should work right away, and this should be fairly straightforward. In order to make all the connection happens, you should watch this other video, but you can open your open stage control and you will need to replace the current MIDI values to what you had assigned as the knobs and the buttons in the character animator. Your puppet will also need to be set up in a certain way for the MIDI control, and when you're sending the values for rotation, your puppet actually gonna rotate appropriately. If you're here, you should be good to go. At the moment, I did not implement any size changing or scaling of the body parts. This would be for the future. It's also a little bit janky at times and a little bit jumpy too much. But what we can do is we can record these MIDI values now and we can replace them, including the smooth replay. And we can go with development of our joint engine model better and better. And it would allow us actually to reuse a lot of recorded animation for the different kinds of characters with different limbs and body sizes, because operating on a joint levels allow us much bigger flexibility. In the future, we will add the calculation of the distance between the elbow and the shoulder and between the elbow and the wrist, and that will allow us to scale the parts of the arm. Let me know if you have any ideas or how to develop this project, or maybe you can try it and something works or doesn't work for me. Let me know. Let's keep improving that, because it does seem like an interesting thing. Especially I like the fact that we can reuse a lot of those animations for the different characters in the future, which would help me a lot since I have 40 characters planned and not a lot of them would have to have fully unique animations. For example, walking can be fairly simplistic and can be fairly similar for the different characters. So we'll be working on it, still working on the closing phrase. Cheers.